It says it's starting. What is it? Comment moderation is not set. What does that mean? Good morning. There they are. Good morning.
Good morning. Just checking to see if we're up.
Can y'all hear us? Can you see us? Is everything broadcast ready? Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3. Quick reminder. Yes, we did turn everything off. Can you hear us and see us? Thought I heard something. They're not responding, so I don't know. She's saying good morning.
Okay, we are. Yeah, they can hear us. Okay. Good morning. Welcome to morning prayer. My name is Neal Michelle, and this is my wife, Varita, and I have one eye this morning. My right eye has no contact lens in it because I am awaiting surgery on my cataract. So if I drop out, particularly during the hymn, again, welcome, and let's begin with the confession of sin found on page 79. Oh, no. Instead, we will
sing a hymn. So our hymn today is hymn number 410, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven. Hymn 410.
Praise my soul, the King of Heaven, to his feet thy tribute bring. Healed, restored, forgiven, evermore his praises sing. Alleluia, alleluia, praise the everlasting King. Praise him for his grace and favor to his people in distress. Praise him still the same as ever, slow to chide and swift to bless. Alleluia, alleluia, glorious in his faithfulness. Father, like he tends and spares us, well our feeble frame he knows. In his hand he gently bears us, rescues us from all our foes. Alleluia, alleluia, what his mercy flows. Angels help us to adore him, ye behold him face to face. Sun and moon bow down before him, dwellers all in time and space. Alleluia, alleluia, praise with us the God of grace.
Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Make known his deeds among the peoples. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor, and you'll find that on page 79 in the Book of Common Prayer. Let us pray.
Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you. In thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Alleluia. Let us say together the Jubilate. You'll find that on page 82 of the prayer book.
Be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Know this, the Lord himself is God. He himself has made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving. Go into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and call upon his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his faithfulness endures from age to age.
Our psalm appointed for today is Psalm 18, verses 1 through 20. It's found in the Book of Common Prayer on page 602. Psalm 18, verses 1 through 20 on page 602. I love you, O Lord, my strength. O Lord, my stronghold, my crag, and my haven.
My God, my rock in whom I put my trust, my shield, the horn of my salvation, and my refuge, you are worthy of praise.
I will call upon the Lord, and so shall I be saved from my enemies.
The breakers of death rolled, and the torrents of oblivion made me afraid.
The cords of hell entangled me, and the snares of death were.
I called upon the Lord in my distress and cried out to my God for help.
He heard my voice from his heavenly dwelling. My cry of anguish came to his ears.
The earth reeled and rocked. The roots of the mountains shook. They reeled because of his anger.
Smoke rose from his nostrils and a consuming fire out of his mouth. Hot burning coals blazed forth from him. He parted the heavens and came down with a storm cloud under his feet. He mounted on cherubim and flew. He swooped on the wings of the wind. He wrapped darkness about him. He made dark waters and thick clouds his pavilion. From the brightness of his presence through the clouds burst hailstones and coals of fire. The Lord thundered out of heaven. The Most High uttered his voice. He loosed his arrows and scattered them. He hurled thunderbolts and routed them.
The beds of the seas were uncovered, and the foundations laid bare. At your battle cry, O Lord, at the blast of the breath of your nostrils.
He reached down from on high and grasped me out of great waters.
He delivered me from my strong enemies and from those who have hated me, for they were too mighty for me.
They comforted me in the day of my disaster, but the Lord was my support.
He brought me out in an open place. He rescued me because he delighted in me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Our Old Testament reading is from the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 3, verses 18 through 28. Deuteronomy, chapter 3, verses 18 through 28. I commanded you at that time, the Lord your God has given you this land to take possession of it. But all your armed for battle must cross over ahead of your brother Israelites. However, your wives, your children, and your livestock, I know you have much livestock, may stay in the towns I have given you until the Lord gives rest to your brothers as he has to you, and they too have taken over the land that the Lord your God is giving them across the Jordan. After that, each of you may go back to the possession I have given you. At that time, I commanded Joshua, you have seen with your own eyes all that the Lord your God has done to these two kings. The Lord will do the same to all the kingdoms over there where you are going. Do not be afraid of them. The Lord your God himself will fight for you. At that time, I pleaded with the Lord. O sovereign Lord, you have begun to show to your servant your greatness and your strong hand. For what God is there in heaven or on earth who can do the deeds and mighty works you do? Let me go over and see the good land beyond the Jordan, that fine hill country in Lebanon. But because the Lord was angry with me and would not listen to me, that is enough, the Lord said. Do not speak to me any more about this matter. Go to the top of Pisgah and look west and north and south and east. Look at the land with your own eyes, since you are not going to cross this Jordan. But commission Joshua and encourage and strengthen him, for he will lead this people across and will cause them to inherit the land that you will see. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And now let us say together Canticle number 8, found on page 85 in the Book of Common Prayer, the Song of Moses, page 85.
I will sing to the Lord, for he is lofty and uplifted. The horse and its rider has he hurled into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my refuge. The Lord has become my Savior. This is my God, and I will praise him. My people, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a mighty warrior. Yahweh is his name. The chariots of Pharaoh and his army has he hurled into the sea. The finest of those who bear armor have been in the sea. The fathomless deep has overwhelmed them. They sank into the depths like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, is glorious in might. The Lord has overthrown the enemy. Who can be compared with you, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like you, glorious in holiness, awesome in renown, and worker of wonders? You stretched forth your right hand, the earth swallowed them up. With your constant love, you led the people you redeemed. With your might, you have brought them in safety to your holy dwelling. You plant them on the mount of your possession, the resting place you have made for yourself, O Lord, the sanctuary, O Lord, that your hand has established. The Lord shall reign forever and forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Our epistle reading is from Romans 9, chapter 9, verses 19 through 33. Romans 9, verses 19 through 23. One of you will say to me, then why does God still blame us? For who resists his will? But who are you, O man, to talk back to God? Shall what is formed say to him who formed it, why did you make me like this? Does not the potter have the right to make out of the same lump of clay some pottery for noble purposes and some for common use? What if God, choosing to show his wrath and make his power known, bore with great patience the objects of his wrath, prepared for destruction? What if he did this to make the riches of his glory known to the objects of his mercy, whom he prepared in advance for glory, even us, whom he also called, not only from the Jews, but also from the Gentiles? As he says in Hosea, I will call them my people who are not my people, and I will call her my loved one who is not my loved one. It will happen that in the very place where it was said to them, you are not my people, they will be called sons of the living God. Isaiah cries out concerning, though the number of the Israelites be like the sand by the sea, only the remnant will be saved. For the Lord will carry out his sentence on earth with speed and finality. It is just as Isaiah said previously, unless the Lord Almighty had left us descendants, we would have become like Sodom. We would have become like Gomorrah. What then shall we say? That the Gentiles who did not pursue righteousness have obtained it, a righteousness that is by faith, but Israel who pursued obtained it? Why not? Because they pursued it not by faith, but as if it were by works. They stumbled over the stumbling stone. As it is written, see, I lay in Zion a stone that causes men to stumble, and a rock that makes them fall. And the one who trusts will never be put to shame. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And now let us say together Canticle 19, the Song of the Redeemed. That is found on page 94. Page 94, Canticle 19, the Song of the Redeemed.
O ruler of the universe, Lord God, great deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. Your ways are ways of righteousness and truth, O King of all the ages. Who can fail to do you homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you only are the Holy One. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Our gospel reading is from Matthew chapter 24, verses 1 through 14. Matthew chapter 24, verses 1 through 14. Jesus left the temple and was walking away when his disciples came up to him to call his attention to its buildings. Do you see all these things? He asked. I tell you the truth, not one stone here will be left on another. Every one will be thrown down. As Jesus was sitting on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately. Tell us, when will this happen? And what will be the sign of your coming? The age. Jesus answered, watch out that no one deceives you. For many will come in my name, claiming I am the Christ, and will deceive many. Of wars and rumors of wars, but see to it that you are not alarmed. Such things must happen, but the end is still to come. Nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be famines and earthquakes in various places. All these are the beginning of birth pangs. Then you will be handed over to be persecuted and put to death. And you will be hated by all nations because of me. At that time, many will turn away from the faith and will betray and hate each other. And many false prophets will appear and deceive many people. Because of the increase of wickedness, the love of most will grow cold. But he who stands firm to the end will be saved. And this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in the whole world as a testimony to all nations, and then the end will come. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And now let us say together the Apostles' Creed, which you'll find on page 96 in the prayer book. Page 96.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary.
He suffered under Pontius Pilate,
was crucified, died, and was buried.